Yes, Photoshop 2021 is out, and I'm just going to show you quickly a couple of these new features that I like. I'm not going to show everything. You can find that on the Adobe website if you want. I'm just going to show you the features I like in this new Photoshop. I'm guessing some of you still use like a cracked version of Photoshop, maybe some older version, so you don't have these features yet. But for the other people that do have this new feature because they have a subscription at Adobe, just have a look at these features that I like. All right, let's have a look at this new feature called Neural Filters. And with Neural Filters, you can change someone's face or make them look different and stuff like that. So here you can enable this. And if you look at Style Transfer, they have also some other styles that you can apply to your photo. But I don't want to use this one for now. I just want to edit this photo with all these effects we have here. Right, so you can see here it's still beta, so it doesn't work that well yet. But it's going in the right direction, and I think I like this. Now, if we look at here, we have like expressions. We can change her face to be more happy. So if we move this slider to the right, her face should change to be more happy. All right, this is pretty cool. The only thing I don't like about this is that they are trying to show some teeth. I'm not sure whose teeth that is. I don't think her teeth will look like that, but all right, it's going in the right direction. This is interesting. And let's try to make her look surprised. So I'm not sure what it's gonna do. Okay, so her mouth is gonna go a little bit open. Like if we do this even more, maybe we can mess her whole head up like that. This is interesting to do if you wanna mess with someone's photo or you can't look surprised on photos, you can make yourself look surprised. Now we can also make her a bit angry if we want to. And here we have other features. All right, so I guess when you're angry, you're opening your mouth like that. All right, this is fun because if you want to mess with someone's photo, you can just do this in Photoshop. You can see here, we get a bit like this blur effect. So it definitely needs some work, but it's going in the right direction. I like it. Let's make her look older. I think facial age should make her look older. All right, she looks older and her hair color changed, I think. So I guess when you're older, your hair color is gonna get gray. This looks a bit blonde. But all right, let's make her gaze. Let's do some hair thickness. Let's also change her head direction. Let's just do everything here and see how this will mess up this photo. You can see here, this looks really weird. This is probably fun to do maybe with your friend's photo too. Just change it like that. And you can have all these funny facial expressions. And this is pretty cool. I like this feature. Definitely needs some work, but all right, it's going in the right direction. We have also some other things here like makeup transfer. This is in the cloud, so you definitely need some subscription for Photoshop to get these things. So probably all these guys are still using some correct version of Photoshop, so you don't have this. But if you have Photoshop subscription, you should have all these things here, right? So I'm not gonna go through all these. You can do that yourself. I don't want to waste your time. All right, the next thing that I want to test is also a neural filter like before, but this is a neural filter to get some color in your image. So maybe you have some old photos and you want to colorize them. So instead of doing this by hand, it's going to take you a lot of time. They have now colorized. And let's try this photo with Marilyn Monroe here and see what it does. And you can see how cool this is. It directly changes this image to a colorful image. And here you can change the settings. Maybe you want a bit more red and yellow to change this color. But I really like this feature because this saves a lot of time. And you can get some, maybe you have some old photos from your grandparents or something. And you want to colorize them. So this is the way to go. Let's also try it on this photo from The Godfather. And go to Neural Filters and colorize. Let's see, colorize here and enable this. And you can see here we directly have this color. Of course, here he does still look black and white. So this filter definitely needs a bit more work, but I really like this. This is really cool to make some old photos colorful, maybe for print or something. And you can just try this out and see it for yourself how this looks. All right, let's have a look at this feature. It's called Sky Replacements, which you can find in the edit menu. If we select this, we can easily change the sky perhaps. So let's first try to change the sky. They have a bunch of skies that you can pick from here. You can also upload your own sky if you want. And let's just try to change the sky here. And let's see what it is. You can see here it does a really good job on changing the sky of this image. We can also change the settings here to make it look better. Increase the brightness to get some more light in this. and you can even scale it to see how this image actually looks. So this is pretty cool because you can also just press OK and you have all these layers from the sky. Eventually you can also just select these and make some editing changes. Now I want to also try this on another image like this one. This should be a bit more complicated for Photoshop. So let's also try some sky replacement here and see how this looks. All right, so this is pretty good, but you can see here we get a little bit of like this drop shadow effect on these photos. So it looks like this feature does a pretty good job, but not for all photos. So definitely needs some work, but it's going in the right direction. And I really like this feature. It's gonna save us a lot of time to change the skies of images. As you can see here, this is pretty cool. The next feature that is new in Photoshop, and that is quick actions. If you go to help, Photoshop help, you get this discover menu, and here we have quick actions. And this is probably for people that may be lazy to cut out images, to cut out backgrounds or blurring backgrounds. So just let's have a quick look at how this should remove the background. If you just press apply here, and you can see here, it doesn't really do a good job for this. So I would probably never use this feature. So let's just press Command Z to go back. And let's just try another one with blue background, for instance, and apply. And let's see how this looks. And you can see here, it doesn't really do something good. So this is probably one of the features I'm not going to use. This is for someone that is maybe new to Photoshop and wants to try out quickly to see how the background changes. But I don't suggest you use this. If you look at the next feature, and that is how you cut out hair and background. So usually what you would do is to select subject, and then you get this selection, make a mask of it. Let's put a background here so we can see this eventually better. And when we press right mouse here, select and mask, we now have a feature here called refine hair. And this should make these hair better, because usually what we will do is do it like this and go around the edge to make this better. So you can see here, this does a really good job. Usually I always use this feature. So you can see this is like pretty perfect. And you also can change background color if you want, but let's leave it like this. Let me go back a bit and use this feature instead of doing it manually. So if we press this, this should remove the hair, the background behind here. And you can see here, it doesn't really work that well. So I would probably not use this, maybe if I'm really lazy and it's gonna work. But it looks like this feature still needs some improvements, and maybe you can change it here to see if this makes it better. This is definitely already better, but I still like to do this manually instead of by Photoshop. So this is not really something I would use. Let's try it also on this photo. Maybe it would work better on a person. So let's go to select and then subject to select her first, make a mask, then press. Let's give it a background here so you can see this better. Always make a black or a gray background to see this better, and then go to select a mask. And now let's press refine here. And you can see here, this does a really better job than with the fog. So this is pretty cool. Of course, it needs some brushing here. If you can see here on different colors, you can see this definitely needs to get brushed. So this is like cool, but when you do this, don't forget to use the clone stamp tool to bring these hairs like to the edge, and you get a nice selection of this hair. One last feature that I really like, that is that you have a search here. I usually always search a long time for brushes, so now I can just search like fur, and I see all these fur brushes I have, or hair brushes, whatever. So you can quickly find all these new brushes. So thanks for watching. If you want to see all the other features, you can check out on the other website. I'll put the link in the description, and I hope to see you on the next video.